As you move to the south, you see that the room is getting bigger. It is lit by many candles, and in the center, you see a large pentagram around which 12 black wizards are standing. At the center of the pentagram shines a bright light. Marmion is standing in front of the light, his hands held high. Alright, well, we have to stop this. As you take a further step forward, Marmion suddenly sees you. He lowers his arms and speaks. Ah, we have guests. So you've actually got as far as this? Very well, you will get no further, and I believe you will not be alive to see Tarbos arrive. Marmion and his 12 wizards attack you. Oh boy. 12 wizards. Oh my god, look at all of them. Hurricane! Hurricane, rock you like a hurricane. Okay. What else? Wait, I don't want to move. No, I want to attack. I'm getting too beside myself. Oh, I think we're like actually getting slowed down by all the animations here of all these figures. Mass haste. He actually has a few arrows left. Oh my god, six? For just such an occasion. We're attacking this. Wait, why? No, no move. Attack whom? Him. Yeah, they're all definitely a him. As far as I know, anyway. She's casting mass haste. I don't know what I should do. I guess nothing. Is there anything I can do until people start getting injured? Yeah, my clicks aren't all registering. Sleep, maybe? I wonder if it would work. Put these to sleep, maybe. They're probably going to resist it. They're wizards, so they have high magic resistance, I would assume. Wizard level 8. Gribben hits wizard level 8. That's interesting. Bee wizard. Weapon is powerless for Silk. This is going to be gnarly. Mist. Doing no damage. Mist. Trazer casts Hurricane. Marmion is immune to the spell. Resisting. Wizard level 12. Immune. Trazer gives. Oh, the front ones were. Oh, nice! Look at that! The wizards in the back were immune. Cool, but we got rid of all the level 8 wizards. Oh, why didn't I get mass haste? It appeared on everyone but me. Too far away from her, I guess. Did sleep work? I think they were immune. Well, there's nothing he can do. Is there something they're not immune to? Maybe a more targeted spell? Monster group? No one got hit. These guys missed. If they cast, I'm sure they cast magic, they're wizards now, but they haven't tried to cast any yet. Even though it looks like they're all about to. And that's Marmion at the end. Yeah, the weapon's powerless. Thunder. Immune. Resist. Immune. Oh well. Powerless. Okay, they need to move up. There's not a whole hell a lot of what we can do. Marmion casts a spell. Okay, he powered up these guys. Obviously. As if they need it. Not sure what our wizard can do here. Maybe they're not immune to certain things? I'm not sure. Can't hurt to try, right? There's nothing much else she can do either. Just in case, give Trasric spell points. Nice. Ribbon getting some hits in there. Nice, one down. Well, seven down. What did I try to cast? Ice Ball. I remember. B Wizard, level 12. What'd they cast? I don't think it worked, whatever they did. Let me just double check. I missed a message. No, we look good. Alright, we'll focus on these now. On this one. Gribben's down 2 points. Yeah, I'm just waiting. Alright. Nothing Silk can do. What does Necklace of Bela do? I think that's, magic resistance. Yeah, it's helping him now, but there's nothing... Assassin's Blade. See if he can move up. I don't know. I don't want to move him up yet. Because then both these guys will probably hit him. Just wait a little bit. Because I'm pretty sure the Assassin's Blade is a magical weapon, so he can... Oh, yeah, I am on him. Yeah. It's got speed, 10, attack. Yeah, it's got bonuses. It's a magic weapon, so it'll probably work against these guys. Whereas, his arrows won't work. And the boomerang, toomerang, sumerang won't work. I wish Trasric's magic wasn't being resisted so much. Try a hailstorm to see. It's a level 12 wizards. I wonder what level Marmion is. We got 8, 12, and I guess Marmion is immune. They're all immune. I bet you disintegrate would have worked. So weird how it says successful. I guess successful in casting it, but it just has no effect. Marmion changed location. I don't see where he went. I wish I knew which one was him. This one? I really don't know. Let's move Silk up. These guys aren't. Actually, let's move him here. So maybe this guy will attack Griban. So I don't have two of them wailing on Silk, because his AC is not nearly as high as Griban's. Anyone need healing? Still down 2 points. And down 16 points. And they're both attacking this one. We'll find out who it is. If it's Marmion. They're hitting Marmion. That's okay. Get rid of Marmion. Maybe the others will run off. Probably not. Remember when enemies used to lose morale and flee? It's been forever since that happened. I forgot all about that. I don't think since maybe the episode 100, the dragon fort, the dragon castle. I think sometimes the firebirds or whatever they were, flame birds, would flee. Just one of them. I haven't been paying that much attention, but they haven't been doing anything. Now he is doing a little damage. Not much. But, you know, if he can help out, because there's only two of us doing anything otherwise. Nice. Silk resisting. Others were not. Oh, these are like, these are damaged. Oof. Okay, they're going to town. Marmion. Oh, he healed them all by 8. Well, that's not much. Alright, so how are we doing? I'm full. Silk is down 55 points. Griban down about 100, almost. Trobonir is actually fine. Okay, I'm gonna heal Griban. Trasric, do you have any healing potions? You do. So heal yourself with one of them. Since you guys aren't doing anything. And Satine can heal herself. I assume she has one. She has 6 of them. Trying to stop anyone from dying here. And these guys are attacking Marmion, and Silk's attacking this one. Get him, Silk. 9 points. Woohoo. Come on, Griban, stop missing! Hit that Marmion. Aw, man. Only 1 out of 4. Made contact. All is healing. Oh, did we get rid of Marmion? I missed that. Alright, Silk is getting blasted. Okay, you hit that guy. You hit that guy. I'm trying to keep these guys alive. Heal yourself. You're not good for anything right now, so just heal yourself. and Isle Hill Silk. Nice hit, Silk. One out of three at least. Okay, another one down. Healing all around. It didn't seem to do much on Silk. Casting a spell. I got hit for a little bit. I gotta move over to him. Or rather, Drobanir does, because he'll just sling spells from over there. And I will heal Silk again. Trazric does not have any healing. Satine does. Tempted to heal one of these guys, but let's wait. Nice! Two left. Oh, he's moving too. Hit Silk for 11. Help him out. Heal Silk. I think I might heal myself. That's a rare thing, to just heal myself. Who's got the least, actually? I have 222. 144. Okay, heal Satine. Actually. Belay that order. Drobanir might just kill this guy right off. Nope, he's done. No damage. No damage. No damage. 7 damage. Okay, you guys are toast. Still not full. Wow. Nor am I. Oh, that's right. He didn't decide not to heal me this time. Silk is just 7 points shy. Gridman can help out now. We might finish this nonsense. 222. 169, which doesn't go much higher than that. Alright, now I will heal myself, just in case. At least then I'll be alive to do more healing. One left. 383 experience for everybody. Too bad we won't use it for anything. 2,396 gold. Too bad we can't buy anything with it. We'll pick it all up, though. We couldn't pick up all the rations. daggers. No one can take the dagger. Well, because we took all the rations. What's this? What happened? I can't even use my mouse to move around. Isn't that weird? It glitched. Ouch. For some reason I thought it said, come on now. Special teleporter. As you walk before the blinding light, you see a being slowly materializing in the light. I do? Almost instinctively, you thrust the Amberstar into the light, and a powerful force surrounds your body. You hear a sudden, long, howling scream, and as it dies away again, the blinding light also fades. I can move around now. Ritual room. I just want to look at these to see if there's anything tricky about them. That's me. That's talking. So who appeared in the light? I wanted to take one of the daggers for as a memento. Okay, so now we go through this. As you enter the corridor, you hear the voice of Chandra. My dear friends, you have made it. Take the teleporter, which I have opened for you. It will take you safely to Twin Lake. You are already expected there. A great celebration is being planned for you. Twin Lake. Cool. Lord Carwayne says, a few brave people have proven that evil is not all-powerful. Let us pray that Tarbos has now been banished forever, and that all life on Lyramion may live in peace. Awesome. The festivities have started. Eat and drink to your heart's content. Let us go on the balcony to behold our beloved Lyramion. I love the music. I love the artwork. This is so awesome. A dragon! Is that okay that there's a dragon? That's the dragon we taught to like eagles. Peace and happiness have returned to Lyramion once more. Even the mighty dragon flies in harmony with the great eagle. Okay, that dragon from the egg grew up very quickly. But dragons are magical. Are giant eagles magical? That's a good question. What's a red thing in the sky? I see two moons, but the red thing is... what exactly? I supposed to... Oh, it's glowing now, the red thing. It's a tear in the fabric of time and space. But why does Lyramion's third moon glow evilly with a blood-red light? Has Lord Tarbos found a new way to free himself? Third moon. The next game is called Amber Moon, guys, and I will be playing it. These questions and more will be answered in Amber Moon, the second part of the Amber Trilogy. And... So I'm going to be playing Amber Moon, yes, and... Amber Sun, unfortunately, was never released. Amber Moon was barely released. Only officially existed in German for quite a while until an unofficial English translation came out, but released by the same team. And only on the Amiga. Unlike this game. Okay. I clicked the mouse button, and that's what happened. Well, I want to thank you guys so much for watching. I really enjoyed playing this for everybody. Very enjoyable. Looking forward to playing Amber Moon. As you know, I'm playing these on weekends only, as you may know. Saturday and Sunday, so depending on what day this goes up, this will go up on either the next Saturday or the Sunday, the next day. Amber Moon, Part 1. Looking forward to it. I really enjoyed the game. The only things I didn't like about it was the whole food and resting thing could have been better. I mean, what do you want for a game from, what, 92, 93? And just the repetitiveness of the enemies. The last dungeon should not have been just filled with slimes over and over. I mean, you could have... I think it would have been even better... to take goblins and orcs and just give them new names, even use the same sprite, you know, and you can kind of use your, you know, imagination as that, you know, that's, you know, I don't know what you would call them. Supreme orcs or something, or, you know, goblin lieutenants, you know. But, I mean, those are really my only gripes with the game. We ended up at the end with more food and more money than we knew what to do with. Which is fine. Found some awesome spells at the end. But then most of the creatures that you go against resist the magic. Which took a lot of the fun out of it. I was so glad just to blast the cave trolls with Hurricane for a few times. Seeing all those points of damage on them was neat. One of my favorite parts must have been right before with that battle, fighting the wizards and just using Hurricane and wiping out an entire row of them. That was freaking awesome. That alone was worth it, just to see that. So, but the individual NPCs, you know, were interesting. The bosses were really interesting. The early quests were really good. I liked the Lord Drebin, where he summoned that water demon, and then fighting the water demon, that was exciting. For some reason, we had two different wine cellars. The wine slime was the first slime we came across. That was pretty cool. The King Rat, I believe it was called, who shrieks out, you know. He's trying to kill all cats and humans, apparently. And then that, you know, the game pulls quite a few dirty tricks on you, like with the, what do you call it, that Jonathan Bergen's house, where you fall down by the door and you're stuck down there, and if you don't have a crowbar, you're not getting out of there. So, and I did not have a crowbar. One of the hardest battles I had to fight, probably because I fought it before I was supposed to, the sprites and goblins, the goblins were fine, but the sprites were in the back, and they looked just like goblins. But, yeah, the spells they would cast on you were pretty devastating. That was a pretty tough battle. I just remember the, you know, the, old tunnel or secret tunnel off into that island with all the endless goblins, and then the dragon castle with all the endless firebirds, and then this last with all the endless yellow slimes. And it's like, come on already, it takes so long just to fight these things. But, I mean, they're minor gripes. It's not going to be perfect for a game from 1992. So, I really enjoyed it. The spells were interesting. I'm going to leave some spells that I just learned about right before the game ended. So, curious to see if we're going to have, I'm sure Amber Moon is very similar. Curious if the spells are going to be the same. I suspect that some of them will be the same, but there'll be some new ones thrown in. You know, at least we'll know what some of them do. Like if we see Magic Sphere, we'll figure what that does. You know, kind of interesting thing that the game did threw you a curve at you with the UI when we were down below in Jonathan Bergen's, right before, well, actually we find it in his laboratory. It's a compass. And then, ta-da, then you not only have a compass on your HUD, your UI or whatever, your display, showing you which way you're facing, but then the plane, like, mark, or I think it was a square, I'm not sure, or rectangle showing you where you are on the map turns into an arrow so that you also know which way you're facing, which was something I was complaining about. I complained quite a bit about it, and it was on purpose. I was like, oh, why can't they just make it so that you know which way you're facing, you know, because I would look at where I am on the map and move a little bit. Okay, I'm moving west right now, so just keep moving that way. You know, and then we found the compass, and ta-da! So that was neat, and how we kept adding things, how we added the Wingate icon or display, whatever you call it. We added the Amberstar on the display. Putting the Amberstar back together was pretty neat. I kind of liked that. It was very forgiving, very unforgiving, sorry. If you didn't take notes, which I did not, take notes, guys, if you guys play it. Well, you just saw me play through the whole thing, I guess. Take notes in the Pharaoh's tomb, Relinook's tomb, because I think it tells you what all the gods are. Geb and Nut and Harasht. I knew what Bela and Gala were from the beginning. There's, like, I think a statue to each one in the Marillion's tomb. And that whole area was pretty neat with Marillion's tomb. I really enjoyed that. And it took me forever to get around to that. Sorry, guys. The reason it took me forever to get around to that was because it was up north, and I tended to think as everything headed towards the Fortress of Godsbane as being tough. So that's why I stayed away from that whole area. So I did not end up going to the Temple of Monks till near the very end. I didn't go to the Hall of Peace till near the very end. The Hall of Peace was like my third last dungeon. I went to Hall of Peace, which was interesting. I enjoyed that. And then we went to, Many Eye. the Castle of Many Eye, and then we went to Fortress of Godsbane, and those are our last three dungeons right there. And the Realm of Many Eye was a definite surprise to me, because I was not expecting to go down a whirlpool, walk around, fight these octopi, spiders, swamp rats, and everything, and then come across a village with people living down there made out of ship hulls. That was really interesting. I like that. Kudos to them. I figured that's it. I've explored all the overland map. I've been everywhere except for Fortress of Godsbane, and there's no more towns left, and then I come across this town with more NPCs to talk to. Pretty interesting. Now, the thing I heard is that, I mean, unfortunately, I don't like the system, the keyword system, you know, where you have to figure out a word to ask somebody about, and they tell you, I don't know anything about that, I don't know anything about that, I don't know anything, or I can't say anything about that, over and over and over again. So you don't want to try a lot of different things, because they don't recognize that many things. They could have put some more stuff in there, you know? But I guess, you know, they had enough discs swapping and everything like that for back in the day. I mean, believe it or not, text took up a certain amount of, you know, space. Not as much as a full-blown graphic does, but still. If you add in a lot of text for people saying, giving replies to everything, I mean, I would make entire episodes of just asking this person everything, asking that person everything, because there'd be so much, you know, if they really do respond about everything, you know, like, oh, I think I've heard of Cora Wayne, but, you know, since I've been down sucked down this whirlpool, I haven't seen him in forever, or I haven't been to, you know, where he lives, I haven't been to Twin Lake in forever to come across him, blah, 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 blah. But, yeah, it would have been interesting. But I know there are certain... I know I'm rambling. You guys can tune out if you want to. The game's over. Goodbye! What are you still doing here? There are certain entries I've heard about where if you ask certain characters certain things, you get a funny response. Of course, you could spend hours trying to figure out which NPC, which thing, you know... And I don't know what it is. If you guys know, leave a comment. Just, yeah. Make a video about it. Love to see it. You know, this game needs more exposure. Can't say any more that I'm the only English YouTuber to complete it. I mean, someone actually completed it before me. His name's Cinetar, and he put up, 6-hour videos of originally streamed on Twitch, and he uploaded them to YouTube. So if you guys want to watch his, it's Cinetar, Cinatar. Seems like a pretty cool guy, and he plays a lot. He finishes so many friggin' RPGs. I'm jealous. You know, it's just, if you play 6 hours a day, and they're unedited completely, so you really haven't, you know, you could just blaze through some of these games. But with the, you know, these people, Cinetar and Alanare and some other people I've seen, they have, like, really good direction with the keyboard and just flying around with different directions and such. I don't know why I don't have such a good sense of direction, especially when everything looks the same, you know, the walls all look the same and stuff. But they're like, you know, dead end, okay, and they'll explore an entire map, you know. If they don't come across anything, you know, fighting them, they'll explore an entire map, like the entrance level of the Fortress of Godsbane, in like 10 minutes. But that's crazy. So, yeah, other than that, I forget. that was Notch glands or something like that, which stands for night something in German, did a partial English playthrough. And yeah, then there's Cinetar, and all I've ever found. I mean, I haven't searched intensively for the last few months, but it was maybe about 4 or 5 months ago from now, I did an intensive search again, and all the other playthroughs or videos, there's one like tips and tricks or something like that, or intro to, and the rest is non-speaking walkthroughs or German playthroughs. There's like 2 or 3 German playthroughs. So there's not much English out there for this game. There's no reviews that I could find, formal reviews or anything like that. It's really hard to find even text reviews on the web looking up things. But yeah, very enjoyable game. Loved it. So glad I played it. Missed it back in the day. Never heard about it until a couple years ago, basically, before I started playing it. And yeah, they rave about it on RPG Codex. I think that's where I heard it. And they was talking about Amberstar, Amber Moon, and they're like, you know, one of the best RPGs from back in the day as far as, you know, the story and the originality and everything like that. Well, some people wouldn't say it's that original. It's kind of similar in a way to the, you know, middle line of the Ultimas, I guess. Ultima 4, 5, 6, I suppose. You know, just, and, I mean, I only really played the first 3 Ultimas so far, but it's basically the same. You've got, you know, an overland map where you walk around, you're looking down on your character, and then you go in a dungeon and it's first person. Of course, back then it was wireframe graphics, and I hated that. That confused me the hell, because I need to see a solid shape. I need to see a solid wall. It's weird to say, but yeah, plus the dungeons were randomized, so if you went back to the dungeon, I'm sure it'd be the same, but I would just give up on Ultima 1, and then I'd, like, boot it back up again. I'm like, I have some maps, and I'm like, did I screw up this map? Because there's supposed to be a hallway going to the left, and there's no hallway, it's going to the right, or there's just, it goes forward with the ladder down, you know, and needless to say that it was randomizing them when I would restart Ultima, so it wasn't my fault, you know, and that would screw me up even more. But games like this, you know, you could see the wall, you could see where you're going, you could pull up a map of your surroundings, you don't have to map it out, and mapping it out is not good for a Let's Play. You know, if I did a Let's Play of something without an in-game map, I'd have a map on the other screen that I'd be following, and people would consider that. Some people would consider that cheating, but I'm like, what am I going to do? Pause? I'm either going to, you know, you're going to either have silence because I'm scribbling on a piece of graph paper, or I'm going to be starting the video over and over again. It's going to be chopped into, you know, 50 different parts just to examine the floor of one dungeon, at least. So, I like games like this to have an in-game map. I really enjoy the in-game map. So, I just have to say, you know, this is my informal review, so I really enjoyed that. I enjoyed the day-night cycle. It was a pain in the butt waiting for shops to open. But then again, you tend to treasure those shops that you can just go into at any time. You know, oh, where in Crystal? That shop's open, you know, 24 hours a day. You know, so it was sweet. I remember back in the beginning, we needed money so much. I was like, I want to buy more arrows. We don't have money. And when you go into the back of the shop in Crystal, the merchant shop, you know, which I didn't hear anyone else talk about. I watched, like, some early playthroughs, and, like, way, way later after I, you know, looked at the beginning of a walkthrough just to see if, you know, did I miss anything? And I didn't miss anything. But nobody mentioned that you can go into the back of the shop in Crystal and just rob the guy blind of like 1,000 gold and a bunch of other things, which I then directly sold back to him. That was hilarious. But I needed that money so much at that time. So it was like, oh, thank you. You know, so I really enjoyed the game. Yeah, I just keep, I'm repeating myself. So I'm going to call an episode here. Thanks so much for watching me play Amberstar. Stay tuned for Amber Moon. And always seek adventure.